A war over whales happening right here in Central Florida.
SeaWorld says its training practices are safe, but OSHA disagrees following the death of trainer Don Brancho, who was drowned by a killer whale in February of last year. The week-long hearing kicked off today.
West News' Dave McDaniel has been in the courtroom all day, and he joins us live right now with the late-breaking details. Dave?
Well, Martha, OSHA is in court with SeaWorld. SeaWorld is basically challenging OSHA's findings that SeaWorld willfully violated safety precautions in the death of Don Brancho. SeaWorld faces a fine, but it's the park's reputation it's working to protect.
The sheer volume of boxes rolled into court shows the work which has gone into this case. The attorney for OSHA says SeaWorld trains its trainers on what behaviors to be aware of and how to amend or alter those behaviors, then tells trainers their safety is dependent on their own training and skill. It says more protection is needed, a barrier between trainers and the whales. SeaWorld's curator of animal training says the level of safety is elaborate, that trainers cannot get near whales until they complete a lengthy training program and only with a spotter on hand for a second set of eyes. Don Brancho was dragged into the pool by Tillicum, a large male orca which had its own separate set of rules because of its size, meaning nobody in the water with him. SeaWorld's curator says Tillicum never showed signs he'd grab a trainer. PETA was here to protest SeaWorld and say OSHA's got it right when it says trainers should not be in the water with killer whales.
By forcing these animals to live in unnatural and unhealthy environments, they are creating a stressful environment for the animals and a dangerous situation for the human beings.
PETA says captivity should end. The Humane Society of the United States disagrees with the SeaWorld belief that it can amend whale behavior.
They are not machines. They are not domesticated animals that SeaWorld can control. They have this idea that they can control these animals, and they can't.
And again, this hearing is expected to last all week, with OSHA continuing to work toward this theory, that SeaWorld knew there was a calculated risk of injury or death, but put trainers in the water with the whales anyway. While SeaWorld will say that it has elaborate training procedures in place, that their trainers did a great job of modifying whale behavior and staying safe themselves, and that Don Brancho's death was an isolated incident. Reporting live in Seminole County, Dave McDaniel, West 2 News.